fiddle. Shut up, Lizzie. Sometimes you're more trouble than you're worth.
Oh, that's bloody lovely, that is. It's the trouble with this world today. The young ones have got no respect for their elders.
Keep it quiet, will you, Doreen?
Oh, zip your lip, Lizzie. You're the cause of most of the strife today.
Well, maybe I am and maybe I'm not. I can't remember.
Well, we're not taking any chances. That rotten bitch is not winning another round with us.
Not if I can help it.
Come on, Doreen. Find all the junk you can and chuck it in here. Well, come on, Lizzie, jump to it.
Oh, Bea, I couldn't even pull the skin off a rice pudding.
Lizzie! Don't you reckon she would have checked this last night?
Yeah, I reckon she probably has. But she'll want to show Dave, and she hasn't come back on duty for another couple of hours. Now, come on, let's get going. Come on, Lizzie, we're supposed to be in the hospital.
Oh, forget the hospital. Take me to the mall.
Well, I was going to, but she was in such a hurry to make that phone call, I didn't get a chance.
I see. Now, I take it Steele is in here.
That's right.
But Mrs. Powell assured me the boiler room had been thoroughly searched.
Not quite. Now, I don't blame her for missing it. If it hadn't been for my informer, I wouldn't have thought of looking in here at all.
Informer? You mean someone volunteered the information?
Well, I didn't use force, if that's what you mean. I don't believe in it.
Good. I'm glad to hear it. Now, still. Well, it's very unusual, I'll agree, but are you sure it's a still?
I've seen similar. It wasn't in here last night. It wasn't!
It's quite all right. Ferguson, I do understand this place can play tricks on you after lights out. Now, if you will excuse me, I have an appointment with Mr. Douglas.
Well, I hardly think that was necessary, do you, Doreen?
I must admit, I was extremely shocked, Bea. What do you reckon, Lizzie?
Oh, God, did she have to slam the bloody